Would you like to learn to make an easy, economical balloon frame for your indoor balloon columns? Let me show you how. First, we're going to need a few items. Half-inch conduit, we need the full 10-foot piece. Any tape measure, I get mine at Harbor Freight for $2. A Sharpie, always a Sharpie. Plenty of those should be around your shop. And most important, a 24-inch bolt cutter from Lowe's. In order to make this properly, I insist on the Lowe's one. You'll see why soon. This balloon column base utilizes a triangle base. So we're gonna be putting the marks and show you how to bend steel with your bare hands. Take your favorite measuring tape and mark your conduit at 13 inches, 13 inches, and another section at 13 inches. That's going to be the triangle base. You're going to twist the conduit 45 degrees and make one more mark at the 9-inch mark. That's going to be the part that comes up and into the center to create the twist you're going to see. All right, open up your bolt cutters all the way. Use the heel of your foot to secure the conduit to the ground. And all you're going to want to do is carefully, lightly crimp just the littlest of bit on each of your markings. So do your first three markings. I like to hold this so it doesn't roll, then hold my foot. Crimp number two, crimp number three. Next, you're going to rotate, find your other mark at 9 inches. You want to rotate 25%, so now you can see all of the crimps. So the next crimp is going to be perpendicular at 9 inches. Carefully add your crimp. Now you're ready to bend steel with your bare hands. Place your heel back at the top of the conduit. Lean down. That crimp is going to give you just enough with the fulcrum of your foot to give you your first bend. Continue bending so you get the first three parts of the triangle going. You can do your first bends on the floor just to get it started. But now that you've weakened the metal a little bit, it's easy with your bare hands to now fashion this into a triangle. You're gonna wanna end up making this piece look just like an arrow. I'm also using the floor to help hold while I bend. And here you go. Looks a lot like a triangle right now. If it's not perfectly flush, this one is not perfectly flush, it is okay to come in and you just move it a little bit with your hands and it'll come down. Now we're going to do one more piece on the ground to show you the rest of the magic. Next, place your arrow on the ground, making sure that the long part of the arrow is on the top. Again, you're going to use your foot and your heel as fulcrum to bend the metal at the weak point. I'm placing my foot down. I'm reaching up, and all of a sudden, we have a balloon base. Now that you've bent it, it may not be perfect. As you can see, this is angled. All very, very, very easy to fix. Find somewhere in the room with a fixed point you can use for measuring. In this case, I'm going to use this part of the metallic logo. And all you're going to do is just eyeball, putting your feet, bend your metal a little bit until you. Now you have a great balloon base for all these great balloon columns that you're about to make. Every one of these balloon columns was made using this great economical balloon column. Stack your balloons, and now you're ready to go. I hope you enjoyed this Bee Design tutorial. Watch for more. Sign up for Bee Gallery at Battalic.com. And remember, be brilliant with Battalic.